It is a timeless image that reflects an age-old fascination, the abilities and capabilities of the human mind and body. Long before this image was created, and now more than ever, the study has continued. The body, how does it do what it can do? By extension, what tools can be designed to assist in work and improve performance? There is certainly no greater example of the application of the results of this research than the manufacturing process. Newer images, these less than 60 years old, illustrate current progress by their own amazingly dated appearance. Automation progresses, physical assistance is limited, and humans, with cognitive ability unequaled and sensory perception unmatched, remain the critical components. Today, familiar images of the advanced levels of automation and robotics reflect the current state of automotive manufacturing. The body shop, a seemingly choreographed showcase of production technology, unprecedented levels of automation, speed, efficiency. The paint shop, formerly a less safe domain of man, is now a cleaner, safer, more efficient environment offering consistent quality and predictable performance. The body shop and paint shop have been changed forever with the implementation of massive robots and exploitation of robotic attributes, strength, consistency, and tireless efficiency beyond any human ability. But what about general assembly, where subsystems come together in the final stage of automotive production? Humans have played and will continue to play the most important role in this, the most intricate part of the manufacturing process. Here, workers need to rely on experience and sight and touch. Decisions and adjustments are made quickly and constantly. The right part for the right model, the speed of the line, placement of the part. The ability of a worker to sense, process, and adapt is obvious and impressive. This worker, Don Bowman, is actually nearly blind but can rely on other heightened senses and experience and has adapted to meet the requirements of the task. All of this underscores the need for a tool that not only lightens the worker's physical requirements of lifting or holding, but also provides task-dependent guidance. That is, it underscores the need for intelligent assists. General assembly requires human involvement, yet these humans have physical limitations. According to the U.S. Department of Labor, overexertion while maneuvering objects led all other disabling events or exposures. This ergonomic liability is, in fact, cited in up to one-third of all cases in manufacturing environments. So the challenge is to assist the indispensable worker. Help to limit the lifting, bending, and contorting while also avoiding the safety hazards of massive, powerful robots. The assist for these general assembly tasks must satisfy ergonomic requirements while maintaining a level of performance that must be equal to or greater than that already in place. The assist tools must improve the worker's ability to prepare, position, and place parts and assemblies while providing consistent and reliable yet simple and safe assistance with repetitive tasks. A worker in this situation must bring in a cockpit subassembly through a limited opening, the door. The assembly must then be oriented, fit, and fastened. A human will encounter ergonomic difficulties with the task, and a robot alone could not accomplish the fine adjustments necessary. The General Motors Robotics and General Assembly Centers have been working with the University of California at Berkeley and Northwestern University to develop these new intelligent assists. UC Berkeley research is currently focused on power augmentation, assists that are operated by humans to augment strength while retaining total control. Northwestern University research is currently focused on guidance, collaborative robots or Cobots that provide invisible or virtual surfaces to help guide workers using only the power of the worker to move components or assemblies. The ultimate solution of intelligent assists for the operator will combine the strengths of two areas of research, power augmentation and guidance. This worker, Gary Apsey, is using a commercially available air balancer to install rotors on a small car. These balancers respond non-linearly to operator input. They do not fully compensate for varying payloads. The operator must carry the uncompensated forces. The intelligent lift assist technology from UC Berkeley provides very responsive, task-dependent power amplification. The assist can adapt to varying payloads because movement is controlled by the operator and can sense and respond to those varying loads. The force that the operator exerts is sensed at the end effector and is used both to control the extender as well as present the worker with a sense of the weight being lifted. Lab tests have shown that intelligent lift assists provide significant ergonomic benefits. The Cobot technology from Northwestern University combines intelligent robotic assistance with human force and perceptory senses. This is Scooter, a prototype Cobot developed by Northwestern University graduate student and General Motors intern Witaya Wannasuphoprasit. The worker provides the force to move the Cobot and its load. The worker is essentially coupled to the passive device through his efforts to move the load. The Cobot offers assistance in moving the load, but more importantly, through a software-driven process, it helps the worker guide the load to its final resting spot. Invisible or virtual walls are programmed in. The Cobot allows movement only within and along those walls. The wheels simply pivot and redirect worker energy along the invisible virtual walls. There are no brakes on this unit. The programming still allows for the worker to see or feel adjustments needed and provide the force necessary to modify the path of the load. Building on the promise of Scooter, the GM Northwestern team designed and built the world's first industrial Cobot, a full-scale prototype Cobot-based door unloader for the Pontiac Grand Am. The doors-off process, the first task in the GA bill of process, requires the removal of the painted door from the painted body shell in order to simplify the remaining GA assembly tasks. The doors-off tool has two primary components, a Scooter-like computer-assisted cobotic base and a non-traditional door removal tool. The cobotic base consists of an integrating platform, a steering handle, three-wheel units, a computer, and some sensing to precisely locate the platform with respect to the vehicle body. Note that the wheels rotate in response to the handle motion in the caster mode. The door removal tool consists of the lift unit. The door unloader, like Scooter, demonstrates all the basic cobotic control modes. For example, the door unloader can enforce a circular trajectory on the operator. The doors-off process essentially requires the operator to position him or herself with respect to the vehicle on the moving line. The precise location sensing and control methods enabled by Cobots ensure that the operator is positioned in all 3 degrees of freedom, X, Y, and Theta. Once positioned, he or she activates the 2-stage lift mechanism, which lifts the door in an imprecise mode, followed by a very precise mode. At the instant that the door is taken off the vehicle, the Cobot executes an escape trajectory that, for quality purposes, clears the door and the unloader from the vicinity of any Class A surfaces on the vehicle. The operator then drives the unit toward the drop-off station, where the door is carried away to the door trim area for installation of equipment like the glass and window regulator. The door unloader and its predecessors highlight the original goals of the project: to provide the assembly line worker with state-of-the-art assist tools, the ability to mitigate ergonomic problems by providing large, easy-to-hit gross targets, and the potential to impact productivity. These cobotic devices are intrinsically safe. There are no unsafe, powerful motors. Without these motors, the cobots themselves appear less bulky and unwieldy to the operator. Finally, as the system is software-driven, it is flexible and adaptive. Research continues to develop the intelligent assist concept further, and while GM won't be producing these intelligent assist devices, GM is working with suppliers to develop and produce intelligent assists that ensure operator safety while facilitating the performance of the operator's task.